Hello my friends, I'm Lusin, and this video is a tutorial on how to disassemble your graphics card and change your thermal paste. The items you need are your graphics card, a set of precision screwdrivers, you can buy them at the dollar store for around $3 like I did, a rag to wipe the thermal paste off and clean your GPU die, rubbing alcohol. Thermal paste. I'm using Thermaltake's TG4. I bought it because it was cheap. I'm not sure if it's good or bad, but I used it for my old AMD A850-600K and it seemed to do the job. But will someone please tell me if the TG4 is good or not, because there are no reviews of it online. The last thing you're going to need is something like a monkey wrench, but it's optional because some of you at home may or may not need it like I very much did. Step 1. Take apart your video card by using your precision screwdrivers to undo the screws and remove the back plate. In my situation, the I.O. port had 4 stubborn screws that would not fucking turn. This is what I needed my monkey wrench for, and I was finally able to get my AMD Radeon 5970 open. Right now, you see, after I remove the backplate, what do I find? More screws! It's alright, look, just watch me take those screws out like a pro. We arrived at the most frustrating part of the video, taking out the bolts on the I.O. port. Let me address AMD for a moment here. Dear AMD, what are you thinking? Please put regular screws on the back. Not these weird looking ones. Regular ones, please! Ugh, taking these out was such a pain. You at home watching are probably saying something like, "Listen, I'm watching and it doesn't seem like a big deal. You got those bolts out, okay? You're just a pussy, stop complaining. Fuck you." No, fuck you. What you're seeing is the very condensed version. I rubbed my fingers raw trying to turn those screws. The way the I.O. port is built got in the way of me turning the screws. I used my multi-tool pliers and actual pliers to turn the bolts, only to end up with failure. And I fucking hate failure. Guys, use your monkey wrench if you had the same problem like me. So I finally got the card apart, step 1 completed. Oh god, look at that. The thermal paste is all dry. Now this was given to me by my brother's friend who obviously didn't change the thermal paste at all ever since he got it. Just look, it turned solid. My card absolutely needs new thermal paste. It's been giving me some issues because I've been really pushing my card hard with Bitcoin mining. My screen has been, oh my god, it's been looking insane lately. I need to, fix this. It's about time. Step 2. Put some rubbing alcohol in your rag and clean your GPU die. I have 2 dies to clean because my graphics card is a dual GPU, so please don't get confused by that. I'm actually using hand sanitizer instead of rubbing alcohol, but it works just as well. Make sure to get it all clean, get every speck of the old thermal compound out, and subscribe to Lusin, but also make sure it's clean. And the other thing I said. Step 3. Using your thermal paste, apply a small pea-sized amount onto your die. It doesn't really matter how much you put on as long as the entire die is covered. Putting more on is better than not having enough. Step 4. Reassemble your graphics card and insert it back into your computer. And that's all it takes. If I helped you out, please like and subscribe. And share with your friends or anyone who needs help with this. If you got anything to say, leave a comment. I'm always happy to read whatever you have. Now the video wouldn't be complete without showing you the temperature differences, and Lusin does not disappoint. So here you go. In the graph, we have an 8 degree difference in idle temperature after we applied new thermal paste, and 4 degree difference at full load. In conclusion guys, if you have your graphics card for a while, I would suggest putting new thermal paste on it. Doing so will extend the lifespan of your card, which no doubt is important. My 5970 is still going strong despite being released in 2009 and having frame rates way above 60fps in the games I play. But I am looking to upgrade my graphics card when I have the money. But until then, I have to make my own card last. I'll see you in my next video guys, bye bye.